friends, we have learnt our chapter 3 and completed, and we have learnt many varieties of topics in that. Right? Wasn't it is helpful for you? Have you learnt it clearly? I hope you learnt and enjoyed that. Let us start with our chapter 4. Are you all interested? Yes. Let us start with our chapter 4, addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction are very important in our life. So students, you have learned addition and subtraction from your previous classes also. Why it is so importantly given for you in each and every step of class? Because it is very important for us. How long or confidently if you are learning it, it helps you, it will help you to add the large numbers, and it helps in many fields. Everybody needs and knows what it is, addition and also subtraction. Okay, let us solve some of the problem here. So students, always keep remember, here are the 4-digit number for addition they are given. Whenever we are arranging the number, the column of a numbers or whatever the way we have arranged the numbers in vertical and as well as in the horizontal way, the number should give some of the gap to avoid the confusion, so that you will learn how we have to add each and. So see, the first step I have written, some of the gap I have given between each and every number. Can you notice that? Yes. In second digit also, below that each and every number I have written that number. Let us add the number. Yes. So 9 plus 3, how much? 9. So 3 is a 10, 11, 12. So 12 directly shall I write here? It is correct? No, it is wrong. I should write just to this one, I should give carry to next house. So we have to keep the carry. Then 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7. We have to add in this row. Okay. 5, 6, 7. So I got just 7. You can write just 7. No need of giving any carry. Okay. Then 2 plus 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. We will get 4. So 4. And 4 plus 1 is 5. If in the last row, if we get 2-digit number, what we have to do? We have to write as it is, because we don't have any other number next to do that, any other number to give the carry. Okay. Second question. 5 plus 5 is 10. Again 10. So write 0 and give 1 carry to next number. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. Again 3 plus 2 is 5. 1 plus 1 is 2. So I got 2570. So we came to know how we have to add the number. Let us see how we have to subtract the number. So students, here I have number 2 and number 3. Always we have to subtract the number, upper number to down, below number. We have to not do 3 minus 2, 1. No, no, it is totally wrong. So what I have to do, I have to subtract 2 from 5. So 2 is a very small 2, number 3. What we have to do, we have to take carry 1 from this number. So it will become 4, and if I give carry, it becomes 12. Not 3, it becomes 12. Okay. 12 minus 3 is 9. Here we will not have 5. We have just 4. Because we gave one number to carry to that number. 4 minus 2 is 2. Again 4 minus 3 is 1. 7 minus 1 is 6. So I got 6129. Let us solve one more problem. So here I have 2 minus 2 is 0. 2 minus 7. Can I subtract number 2 to 7? No, because 2 is a smaller number than 7. So what I have to take? I have to take carry. 3 becomes 2. If I give 1 carry, 2 becomes 12. 12 minus 7 is 5. Okay. Here I have 2. 2 minus 4. Can I subtract it? No, it is not possible. Again, I have to take carry here. 4 becomes 3. 2 becomes 12. 12 minus 4 is 8. Okay. Now, here I have not 3, not 4. So, 3 minus 1 is 2. So, students, I hope you understood. Please write it and practice it so that you will understand clearly. So, I hope you understood this. Thank you so much for watching the video.